It says forest function label is not supported. While creating Active Directory domain controller in Windows Server 2008 R2, if you select forest function label and domain function label is Windows Server 2003, you will face this type of message or issue. If you select Windows Server 2008 or 2008 R2, this issue will not pop out for you, or you will never see this type of issue. To fix this issue, go to domain controller, which is Win2K8R2, and this is domain controller here. Rise domain function label, here it is. Current domain function label is 2003. Now I'm going to change to R2, 2008 R2. Raise, okay. Now check again. Yeah, that's fine. Sorry, close and go to Active Directory domain and trust for the forest function label here. Raise forest function label, and current function label is server 2003, and change to 2008 or 2008 R2. I will continue with Windows Server 2008 R2. Raise, okay, and check once more time. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, now go to the new server and click next. Okay, this issue is fixed. And where is next issue? It says file replication service FRS is duplicated in new server, like server 2016 and server 2019. To fix this issue, we need to run some PowerShell command. Go to Active Directory domain controller, which is Win2K8R2, and open PowerShell and run as administrator. Okay, first command, replication eadmin sync all force apud. Okay, there is one error in command, SYNC, not sys. Okay, sync all, hit enter, that's fine. This is good message. And second command, dfsr migration mig mig space set global state, set global state 1, that's fine. Then after, third command, dfsr migration mig space slash get migration state, that's fine. And fourth command, dfsr mig set global state, two, hit enter, same, three, that's fine. Now go to services, and search for file replication service, that's fine. And set disable, apply, and stop. Okay, it is stopped and disabled now. Again, we have to click next. That should be fine now. Yeah. And create directory service restore mode password. Click next. That's fine. Next. Yeah, from here, if you have more than one domain controller, you can select from here from which domain controller you want to replicate. But in this demo environment, I have only one domain controller, that's why I'm going to pick this one. Next, this is the path for EDDS database. I will continue with a default path. Click next again. This is the summary. And from here you can see the script. Click next. All prerequisite checks pass successfully. Click install to begin. Now it is upgrading forest, upgrading the domain, installing the DNS and group management policy or group policy management. Okay, this server was successfully configured as a domain controller. That's very good. And we need to restart the server one more time. Close, close. Now it is restarting. In meantime, let's see what is our next step. Okay, we finished fourth step. Now we need to transfer EFSM role to new server. Server is restarted. Let's log in again. Let's open command prompt, run as administrator. Netdom query FSMO. Sorry, not DOM, DOM. FSMO roles are still in the Win2K8R2. Now we are going to transfer to the new domain controller or new server. Go to tools, active directory, users and computers. Go to your domain controller and go to operations masters. Here, operation master is Win2K8R2 and I'm going to change to the Win2K19. Change, yes. Same this PDC, change, yes. And infrastructure, change, yes. Okay, now check again operations masters Win2K19. Yeah, that's fine, great. Close. And we transferred these three. Now we have to transfer domain naming master. For that, go to tools, active directory domains and trusts, operations master. There is Win2K8R2, change, yes. Okay, close and verify one more time. Yeah, there is 19. That's great. Now we have to transfer this fifth role, schema master. For that, open a management console, MMC. Yes. And file, add remove snapping. And from here we have to select active directory schema, and there is no active directory schema. For that we have to register active directory schema DLL. regsvr32 space scsm schema mgmt management.dll. Hit enter. It says schema management DLL is registered successfully. Okay.